Simon. All right, it's been my pleasure to be your MC today, and it'll be my pleasure tomorrow to be here listening to equally great speakers. And the last word, Lucy Riley will be speaking with you.
You know you've got some dedicated activists who sit in this heat for 8 hours. I want to give you, give yourself a hand. So, on your tables, and some of you in the back, have a sign that says VETO AB840. And Jonathan, I want to assure you that I am an organizer. And folks, if you could, actions are all about optics, okay? So the more concentrated we look as a group, the better. I want to encourage those of you in the back to come forward, find an empty seat, fill in the space. Our folks who are live streaming in the front are going to be live streaming this action, and we're going to be sending it out to Jerry Brown. We want to send a message to Jerry Brown, who has this bill sitting on his desk right now, that we need each and every area of the count involved in the audit. We need provisional ballots in the audit. Audits will save our democracy. All right, folks, I want you to practice. We're going to say this 5 times. Jerry Brown, do the right thing. VETO AB840.
Jerry Brown, do the right thing. VETO AB840. Jerry Brown, do the right thing. VETO AB840.
Jerry Brown, do the right thing. VETO AB840.
The booth is in the blender.
Okay, let me just say one thing. This is Ray Lutz. I want to make a correction. This is not just about provisionals. This is about all the later vote by mail ballots and the provisionals, which is about 40% of a typical election in California. 40% of the ballots will be left out due to this sneaky move by a conspiracy of Alex Padilla and Registrar of LA, Dean Logan. By sneaking this in on August 24th, after all the committee meetings were over, and there was no real chance to get this exposed. There was another bill about 15360, the 1% manual tally, that was already being processed. It should have been put in that bill. Instead, they put it inside another bill only about signatures on vote-by-mail ballots that had nothing to do with the audit. And put that through, normally, no one would have noticed. The only reason that I found out was Cammy Foote, the registrar of Inyo County, blew the whistle on it, let me know about it, and then I called Jim Soper, and we got a good response from the activists on stepping forward to put an end to this. But normally, this would have gone on without a whimper because no one knew what these audits were about. No one knew what they were about. We sued Michael Vu in San Diego, brought this to the surface so everybody learned, okay, this is what they're doing. They're leaving 40% of the ballots out, almost all of these counties. And our lawsuit then brought this to a head. And that's why they had to sneak this piece of crap bill through to try to get around doing the right thing. It had 10 years to get these audits done correctly. It was put in law 10 years ago in 2006. They have had 10 years to get it done right, and they've been sidelining and not doing it correctly. And you know, frankly, KCO, I think, is an organization that has nothing to do with election integrity. It's to do with trying to subvert it. We need to get this bill vetoed because it is a catastrophe.